Hello, and welcome to this week's Movie Map, where Tom Hanks and Clint Eastwood together successfully piloted Sully to a successful takeoff at the box office. And thus, our conversation about star power continues. Yes, we've been having quite the spirited debate as to whether or not movie stars still exist, and Sully offers concrete evidence that at least some of the time, they exist both in front of and behind the camera. And this box office performance, coming in way ahead of industry expectations, reminds me of a famous quote from Paul Newman, who admitted that he didn't always have the best box office numbers. However, he said, "When you cast me in the right role, I'm priceless." And by that he meant his paycheck, because he was able to deliver at the box office. And once again, Tom Hanks and Clint Eastwood are able to do so by targeting their prime demographics. See, Sully is the fifth biggest opening ever for the month of September, but the best opening ever for an adult drama, just edging out The Equalizer, starring another older actor who is priceless when cast in the right role, Mr. Denzel Washington. Although, considering the bad reviews for the upcoming Magnificent Seven movie, perhaps there he's not cast in the right role. Because that's a reteaming, by the way, of his Equalizer director, Antoine Fuqua. But we'll be talking about that movie soon enough, and we'll see how it does at the box office indeed. But we're talking about Sully here. And Sully really delivered the older moviegoers. 90% of the audience over the age of 25. I don't see top. Maybe that's the problem with Dan Brown franchise, you know, the Angels and Demons. We'll be talking about that in just a moment. But Tom Hanks perhaps doesn't have any younger appeal, right? So 90% over the age of 25, 63% over the age of 50. So, wow, there not a lot of middle ground. And then 56% female, interesting to see it skew in that direction, 44% male. Eastwood, this is nice for him. It's a nice little cherry on top of his American Sniper Sundae, which was delicious. That did incredibly well at the box office. And it's interesting to see here, although this didn't open as big as American Sniper, so I guess you could argue in either direction, but he seems to have done just fine here, despite his recent very controversial interview, where he not only said that he was pro-Trump, but made fun of anyone who complains about any social injustices in the world. You check out that interview if you have not seen it. I'll put a link down below in the video description. But he seems fine, and his son was also a big part of that interview. But Tom Hanks really needed this. Again, I don't see this helping him with like a trendier, hotter, cooler film. He's not gonna be in Suicide Squad 2, although never say never, because they have no problem, of course, with the rest of their cast attracting a younger crowd. But his box office numbers as of late have not been good. Bridge of Spies, 15.3. Captain Phillips, 25.7. A recent high for him until now. And that's actually right where they expected Sully to come in. But it came in like almost, about $10 million above that. Cloud Atlas, 9.6. But you could always blame that in the Wachowskis. And then Larry Crown, he has no one to blame but himself with just 13. The only problem is the Dan Brown franchise, and he has another entry coming up in just about a month, Inferno, and that's expected to open right around where Sully did, which is a dramatic departure from where the first two of those films opened. And what do you know, those have been his two biggest box office openings to date, not counting, of course, his voiceover work, which is phenomenal, but we're just talking about stuff where you can see his face, because, that's where the big money is, although I'm sure that Disney and Pixar pay him quite a bit for his work as Woody. But we'll see. Either this will help Inferno and maybe boost it a little bit so it comes in not quite so embarrassingly. I'm sure Felicity Jones is like, please don't handicap me going into Rogue One. Let's go. Let's pull this thing forward. And also they'd love to see it come closer to the other openings. Or it will do horrible and it will stop any momentum that Sully could be providing Hanks going forward. So if he wants to close some movie deals, I would advise him to do it now before, just in case Inferno crashes and burns, which, again, looks likely in just about a month. So he's got a 3-week window here to make some movie deals. I'm sure his management team is already hard at work. Although Tom Hanks is such a self-generator of work these days, for instance, a hologram for the king, but when he self-generates work, it usually doesn't do so well. So maybe he should stop doing that. Although I really like The Hologram for a King, but it's such a business-centric movie, I can see why it didn't appeal to a mainstream wide audience. But I liked it, and if you're looking for something to rent during what's obviously a slow period, why not give it a whirl, to quote Home Alone. Now, speaking of getting your target audience out into the theater, When the Bough Breaks did a pretty good job of this. What do I mean by pretty good? Well, let's see here. 71% of the audience was African American, so they're still not doing a great job of getting white, like non-African American audiences to see these movies, even though, of course, African Americans go to see a ton of movies that have very few African American characters in them, sometimes none at all. But, you know, it still is not a two-way street when it comes to box office results. 59% were women, 70% over the age of 25. Not so great for Morris Chestnut, because apparently his audience is considerably older. Although a lot of people made a deal about his social media outreach. They were trying to turn him into like some kind of junior Dwayne Johnson, being like, look how many followers he has, like 6 million. That's nothing compared to Dwayne Johnson, by the way. And he couldn't get them out into the theater. In fact, this was a big opportunity for Morris Chestnut to finally be the star. Last year, this spot was held by The Perfect Guy, and he had to be second banana to Michael Ealy. And this debut for When the Bough Breaks, it makes Michael Ealy look good, but he already looks good. This makes him look even better because it's about 10 million below where The Perfect Guy debuted about a year ago. And then the year before that, Idris Elba debuted in the same weekend, same kind of movie, same kind of box office, 24.2, and both those movies ended in the 50 million range. So maybe When the Bough Breaks can make up some ground and still get into the same finish zone, but as for coming out of the gate, not as strong as Michael Ealy and Idris Elba. So we're gonna have to look for a similar actor for next year when a quote-unquote African-American thriller hits theaters, because it's been a good weekend for them, for that kind of movie. I wouldn't stop supplying that if I could, because they're so cheap to make. But When the Bough Breaks shows a little bit of a stumble with that kind of film. Now, as I said, older audiences really like this weekend's fare. Sully, 90% over 25. When the Bough Breaks, 70% over the age of 25. Which means Hollywood left a lot of money on the table, because the rest of the top 10 looks pretty dismal. So while some people showed up, some under 25, 25 and under showed up, they could have potentially wooed more into the theater. There were two other new wide releases which didn't woo anyone into the theater, The Wildlife and The Disappointments Room, two of the lowest openings of the year. In fact, two of the lowest openings of all time. As for holdovers, Don't Breathe and Suicide Squad, two very young, the under 25 skewing movies, they held up okay. They were able to take the third and fourth spot. But they still tumbled quite a bit. It was a rough weekend. They both fell near 50% in their third and sixth weekends, respectively. But let's talk about Suicide Squad, which just passed 700 million. It just stuck a little toe over the 700 million line, and celebration is indeed in order. As I've said before, it's at least in the same ballpark as Guardians of the Galaxy and Deadpool, which is cause to celebrate. It also just hit Japan, where it opened with 3.6 million, putting it in the same league as Deadpool and Batman v Superman, which had similar openings. And those films ended their Japanese runs with 18.9 million and 16.5 million, respectively. And this is the last country for Suicide Squad to hit. So this is the last pocket of money that's out there. And overall overseas, it pulled in 10 million this weekend. So I would expect it to end with 720 or 730 overall, which is very, very nice. I think that the number one thing on the to-do lists for both Suicide Squad 2 and Deadpool 2 would be to get a China release, because clearly they could have both made a considerable amount of more money if they had gotten into that very lucrative space. Even more money than they both already made, which was impressive as it is. Really, that's like if you have to look for something to say they need to do, because both of them should be very proud of themselves. And in the comics, Red Tool and Harley Quinn have been flirting. So it's the crossover that perhaps we all need, right? If people want to gang up against Marvel, maybe Fox and Warner Brothers could become friends. The enemy of my enemy is my friend. Or hot date. As for the rest of the top 10, big drops across the board, just like Suicide Squad and Don't Breathe in the 40 to 50 percentiles. But at least Hell or High Water stayed in the top 10. Woo! And also Sausage Party. Oh, it's crawling, even with its guts all hanging out. And it's dirty laundry with that scandal with its animators out there for everyone to see. It's crawling towards the century mark. It's really, really lost a lot of momentum, but it could potentially get there. Then for this coming weekend, we'll see how everything does. Horror is set to win the weekend yet again. How much horror can everyone handle, right? Because we're just coming off of Don't Breathe. But this is pedigree horror. This is Blair Witch. So that's set to easily win the weekend. Then as for Bridget Jones, it's Renee Zellweger versus the face shamers. She's had a lot of controversy over her plastic surgery and the way she looks today. She looks pretty much the same to me. I don't know if everyone's making such a big deal about it. I'm not like, who's that? I'm like, it's Renee Zellweger. But anyway, that's expected to open at a number that would be a huge improvement for Renee Zellweger as, you know, in light of her recent box office openings. Well, actually, she hasn't had any really recent box office openings, but in terms of her last box office openings. But it would be a huge disappointment for the franchise that she's, you know, still thankfully starring in, because it had much better numbers in the past. Then as for Snowden, ooh, looking much more like a Joseph Gordon-Levitt opener than an Oliver Stone opener. So, another conversation about star power. And sometimes, even though I know a number of you like Joseph Gordon-Levitt, he's one of those actors, if you look at his overall box office, that when he's the star, most audiences just ain't interested. Even when he's playing Snowden. All right, so Snowden's an interesting conversation. And I just for a moment here, I'd like to say that, you know, he risks so much and is now a fugitive and living in Russia and can't return home. And nobody ever really talks about anything that Snowden, you know, uncovered. He did all this to tell the world and to tell America and say, look what you don't know. And America was just like, meh. And so now he's stuck on the run forever, with really nothing to show for it. So it's a very weird thing, and I'll be interested to see if the movie comments on that at all. And as you can see, no one cares about this movie either. All right, so that's the weekend box office. Thank you so much for tuning in. I love talking about this with you every week. I look forward to continuing that conversation down below, and you can check out some more videos right now.